Well, good Wednesday morning, everyone. I'm so glad you tuned back in. This, for me, is the most exciting end of our trip into Romania that it could possibly be. I hope I say it well enough for you to capture the gravity of the moment. That's at the end. So sit back, enjoy what God has done. And I pray that he makes it real to you. God bless. See you tomorrow.
We've already told the story the last 2 days. I hope you tune into those and take a look of the amazing things that God has done. Our verse for the day is, remember the wonders he has done and his miracles from 1 Chronicles 16. That's what we're doing. I use the same verse all week because I want you to do just that as I'm doing it. We left off yesterday at the church service and just the amazing way that God orchestrated what the choir was singing to what I was going to be talking on that morning. But after the service was over, and again, we weren't allowed to speak to anyone because that'd be terrible for them. They would be taken in for questioning. So we were whisked off, and that broke my heart. I wanted to talk to those people so badly. We were taken to an engagement party for a young couple. And in typical Romanian politeness, we were put right in the front table and sat with them. It was like we were the guests of honor and not the couple, but it was for them. Now, understand that there is no food in Romania at the time. So the whole church had saved up food for, I was told, for 30 days, pooled all of it so that that one party could have food. We're sitting there, and Joe and I keep saying, no, don't give us no food. No food. We don't need it, you know, but they did, and it was amazing. So that party finished, and then before we left, because we were leaving the town that day, we went back to the pastor's office, and on the way, they said, you must take, as our gift to you, these bags of food, like a doggy bag. I said, no, no. They would not take no for an answer. And so the pastor said, you will offend them if you don't take this food. So we did it. We go back to his office now to have a final talk before catching the train to go back home, actually. And we're sitting there in his office, and we said to him, I just want you to know, I said, what could we in the West, what could we give you that you need the most? And he says, we have lots of physical needs, but it's nothing compared to the Word of God. Please keep bringing us Bibles. My people don't have Bibles. And the Bibles you just brought in, they will hand copy. Hand copy. And how many of us have, you know, 10 Bibles at home, don't read them, but one or two maybe? And so I was just blown away by that. And I think it's helped me remember to take the Word of God seriously to this day. Well, we get up from that, we prayed together, and then he took us down to the train station, and we're waiting for the train to come that's going to take us back the 50 miles to Timișoara to change trains again and take us to a border town for that night. That was the plan. We get down to the train station, we're waiting for it, he says goodbye and leaves, and I said to Joe, this is amazing. We don't have the food. We left it in there, and he didn't, and we don't, you know, I'm so glad they'll use it. I no more or less say that, and we see a boy in the distance running with bags. And the pastor had a boy take the bags of food and bring it to Joe and me so that we'd have something to eat that night on the train. What a lesson for Joe and I in the area of loving your neighbor, loving, just loving. We were blown away by that act of kindness on their part. Well, here comes the train then, and I pull out the tickets, and I notice that I had one ticket. And I said to Joe, I've got bad news. I lost your ticket. And he didn't agree with that exactly. But anyway, he says, then listen, you have to pray. By now, my faith is sky high. I know, what's the big deal? And sure enough, so we took the used tickets from the morning that had already been punched and clearly used. And when the conductor came down, that's what I handed him, praying, please, please, Lord, I don't know what's going to happen, but we will never make any of the rest of the connections if we don't get on. And he just acted as if they weren't punched, punched them again, handed them back. A small thing, but one that I was totally appreciative of the Lord. Well, we get back. We go to Timisoara. We change planes, trains. It's now the evening. You can imagine we've gone to a party all day. It's now nighttime. We get to the border town and maybe another 50 miles. So now we're 100 miles from that village. It's now 12 hours since the church service ended. And we land in this city, and again, no taxis. Now, we had been given one big instruction, and that is, do not stay in the train station overnight. Because with this prison release, because there's no food for the prisoners, that's exactly where they go. And you do not want to be there. But what are we going to do? And so I said to Joe, you know, we were told to talk to no one. And we're not, but we're done. We've had our time in Romania. And tomorrow morning, we're going to get back on the Orient Express, cross into Hungary, and we'll be done. But tonight, we have to find, we had a reservation in a hotel, but with no taxis, how do you find the hotel? So this time, there was no angel that grabbed us by the arm and took us. But we're there, and I said, Joe, see that girl walking along there, a young girl, maybe, I don't know, 20. But I'm just saying, she can't harm us. I'm going to go ask her where this hotel is. And he says, all right, you're not supposed to, but go ahead. So I went over to her and I said the name of the hotel. It's all I could. I figured she could get that. I know no Romanian. And she said, she looked up at me, and I'll never forget this. She said, Sister California. And I said, what? Sister California. I may not look Romanian, but do I look Californian? I mean, I thought, no, how in the world can she, what's she saying? Well, after we talked, in a while, it turns out that she had been in that church service 100 miles away in a little village, 20 train stops away, 12 hours later, and I'm the one who picked her out of the crowd. And she knew that I had said greetings from California, and she, her sister, lives in California. And I thought, Lord, you are amazing. I just don't know what else to say. Because, Lord, you led me to this young girl. I know that as a fact. She did not seek us out. We sought her out. And she knew exactly who we were. Statistically, an impossibility. But it was true. It was true. And it happened. And I remember the wonders God has done and his miracles, and I'm forever thankful for those. I really appreciate that the last 3 days you've been listening, because it brings great joy to my heart to be able to share the miraculous God whom we worship and serve. And I hope you have some stories, maybe not that dramatic or whatever, but if you have a friend or whatever, you know God has answered your prayer. That's the same God, and he'll do wonders and listen to you right now. Have a blessed day. And I won't worry about tomorrow.